and the president's vision to upgrade the youth potential.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now, you see, youth normally has a very strong energy. Mm. And to put them inside the classroom and give them just to feed them or spoon feed them with the information, it is not that much interesting for them. Like my students, sometimes we take the entire class outside. The class size is not that big. We sit outside, we discuss. Sometimes we do.
So this is what we call the educational climate.
Yes.
That reflects positively, definitely, on
the information. And definitely, if you can get them to be involved in any kind of sports, they don't have to be champions, but they have to do something. It takes a lot of their mind from being selfish to work with groups. And by the way, there's one of the important thing I forgot to mention before. We have a big problem that we do not, and unfortunately, I don't see even in this new program, you do have it, that we teach interpersonal communication.
Mm.
We don't have this one, we don't have body language, we don't have negotiation. All of them, communication.
Interpersonal communication goes inside the leadership program. Like I had with me last week the designer of the leadership program at the presidency, Dr. Khaled Habib, and he emphasized that they are working on that.
Leadership in the part of interpersonal, this much big.
Yeah.
There was a lot of things. The doctor said interview. Interview has books. And full book. How to can do the, you write the resume, how you can get into the interview. Leadership is a part of the interpersonal communication. They have a lot of things going on. Negotiation, one of them, leadership, conflicts, a lot of things.
Right.
Then you cannot say, you cannot say interpersonal inside leadership. It's the other way around.
Right. Well, more than one aspect actually in Egypt's Vision 2030, and the youth are the bulk. The youth are the center for the whole state, and main center and focus also for the debate for tonight. Short break, and we'll be back.
قررت أن يكون العام 2016 عاما للشباب المصري. أصدرت حزمة من القرارات والتوجيهات إطلاق البرنامج الرئاسي لتهيئ الشباب للقيادة إطلاق مشروع بنك المعرفة المصري دعم وتنمية المشروعات الصغيرة والمتوسطة تخفيف أعباء خدمة القروض عن كاهل الشباب المصري إجراء من تنفيذ بناء 145 ألف وحدة سكنية بالإسكان الاجتماعي للشباب خلال عام 2016 تحديث المناهج التعليمية لجميع المراحل الدراسية توسع في النشاط الرياضي والارتفاع بمستوى اللياقة البدنية للشباب المصري إحياء دور قصور الثقافة وإقامة المسابقات الفنية إطلاق منتدى للحوار مع الشباب مؤتمر وطني للشباب يعقد بمدينة شرم الشيخ خلال شهر سبتمبر القادم لا تتخلوا عن تجربتكم تمسكوا بوطنكم تمسكوا بالأخلاق وصحيح الدين تسلحوا بالعلم وواكبوا العصر وبقوة شبابها ستحيا مصر تحيا مصر تحيا مصر
I'm not sure if I'm back again.
قررت أن يكون عام 2012 عاما للشباب المصري. أصدرت حزمة من القرارات والتوجيهات البرنامج الرئاسي تهيئ الشباب للقيادة، اختلاق مشروع بنك المعرفة المصري، دعم وتنمية المشروعات الصغيرة والمتوسطة، تخفيف أعباء خدمة القروض عن كاهل الشباب المصري، إجراء من تنفيذ بناء 145 ألف وحدة سكنية بالإسكان الاجتماعي للشباب خلال عام 2016، تحديث المناهج التعليمية لجميع المراحل الدراسية، توسع في النشاط الرياضي والارتفاع بمستوى اللياقة البدنية للشباب المصري، إحياء دور قصور الثقافة، إقامة المسابقات الفنية، إطلاق منتدى للحوار مع الشباب، مؤتمر وطني للشباب يعقد بمدينة شرم الشيخ خلال شهر سبتمبر القادم. لا تتخلوا عن تجربتكم، تمسكوا بوطنكم، تمسكوا بالأخلاق وصحيح الدين، تسلحوا بالعلم وواكبوا العصر، قوة شبابها ستحيا مصر، تحيا مصر.
Long live Egypt with a sense of transparency, definitely. Dr. Aya, while reading further in the president's speech, he was also concentrating on fighting corruption.
Right.
Combating corruption and achieving a sense of transparency is very important at this juncture.
Right. First of all, let me say that we just returned back from a visit to the Transparency International.
Mm-hmm.
And the good news about it is Egypt's level of corruption, it has become better. We cannot say that in terms of totally, but it was like number 88 instead of number 114 all over the whole countries. So let's say that we are on our way. The concentration of the president on corruption, because you cannot have administrative reform without fighting corruption. Because in a way or another, if you want to have like social justice, if you want like in an over in terms of job, for example, if you're choosing for youth job openings, now, for example, the Ministry of Manpower, they are announcing four positions. So now you have the country is into the stage of the civil service law, the new civil service law.
Right.
Within all that, this is like administrative reform and opening the door for, I mean, fairness and social justice for everyone to have equal opportunity for to have the job. But if you don't fight corruption, and corruption it's like an internal system that if it is very deep and very strong, you can hardly detect it. So the point is, you need to get like into the system very deep. Like for example, if you remember, Egypt was a few years ago, we were running into, through Dr. Ahmed Darwish, through electronic government.
Right.
The idea of electronic government was mainly to cut corruption because it was a replica for many of the countries who managed to cut corruption. Because right. instead of having serving, being served by a government, a civil servant, and opening the door just for any sort of bribes, now you are having your driving license and anything to do online. So right. there is no chance for this bribes or internal corruption.
Right.
This is not spread only in terms of service, but it is everywhere. So I think this is a very important aspect in the country that we should concentrate on.
Definitely. Well, talking, Professor Azmi, about also encouragement of SMEs, it's very important because when the youth are also engaged in that respect, I guess it's going to help them all through the way and also further provide them with a sense of how to be a young, successful entrepreneur.
We had an experience of a project like this. We call small business administration.
Yeah.
They get young people who would like to do business. They teach them how to do it. Because doing business, visibility study is not easy. And as you can see, the president himself said that we will make someone sit with them, we'll give them the money, but someone sit with them to see exactly if their project going to be successful or not, which is very important.
Yeah.
So once you have such group, which is small business administration in each area, and young people will go to see them, they will predict, okay, I'd like to do this thing. He will tell me, yes, this will work or doesn't work, how you will apply it, how
points
much money.
Points of strengths and points of weaknesses.
Yeah. Then you have to have professionals who will guide those young people, encourage them to do something, because honestly, everyone, once I ask my students about unemployment, we discuss the subject. I said, okay, how much you'd like to get as a salary? 3,000, 5,000, 3,000, 8,000. Okay, who would like to work in McDonald's?
No ads, please.
Who would like to work in Starbucks?
Sir, no ads means we cannot mention the
names. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Okay.
Anyway. So, whatever institutions, you give them, the right way forward. You give them the chance of, like, to know the strong points in this place, and
we have to change their culture too. We have to tell them, it is not that you have to have a big job because you are from a good family or background family or. You can start doing business, you can start doing work by yourself. You can get something and do it, and you'll be very successful. This is the important thing, this is the key. How to get them to be successful is to change their background culture, which unfortunately guide them, okay, unless I'll be manager, I'm not going to do it, which is the problem.
Well, that's what we were talking about, Dr. Aya, training the trainers, those who are addressing those, the kids, since the kids are like growing up, building their personality, building leadership. Let's talk about building leadership, but first this report, and we'll be back.
Egypt launched on Wednesday the final draft of the country's sustainable development strategy for the next 15 years.